I'm Jared Ellishaw from the School of Education. Today we're going to be talking about using the quiz module in Moodle to add questions to a quiz that we have already set up in Moodle. So we've set up the quiz, that is, we've set up the parameters of the quiz, and now we've got to go and get some questions into this quiz. So you go to the quiz that you set up, you see this screen here, then there are a number of items to in the menu on the left, and we want edit quiz. Okay, and this is where you start adding questions to the quiz. Now, one of the features of Moodle that is really very powerful is you have the option of question banking. You can create a lot of questions, store them in various formats so that they're in Moodle and they are available to be used in more than one quiz. So that's a decision you have to make, is do you want to use it for item banking purposes to create a collection of questions, which you will then pull from in the future to assemble quizzes, or do you want to do it just by single quizzes? You can do it either way. But if you're going to use the question banking function, you have to create some categories for those questions. So you go to the menu on the left and choose question bank, then you use categories, choose question bank categories, and then you see this screen here. In your course, you automatically have one default category, and that's essentially the name of your course. That's your parent category. In any particular course in Moodle, you have that default category. Then you can add additional categories. For instance, for the lack of any better term, I'll just say I want a category for quiz 4. And then I'll add the category. Click Add Category. I don't have any questions in that category yet. You'll see that I have added some categories for a variety of things in this particular screen in this course. For exam 1, I have 20 questions already in there. For exam 2, I have no questions. For exam 3, I have no questions. For quiz 1, I have 18 questions in there already. And we're going to take a look at how we get those questions in there. You can add as many categories as you want to. You can categorize by topics. You might have a set of questions on DNA. You might have a set of questions on plate tectonics. Whatever fits your particular course and however you want to group your questions for use later. Then, after we get our categories set up, we go back to Edit Quiz. And notice we have an empty page in Demo Quiz 1. We have no questions in this. To the right side, you'll see default category. This is the default category that you have. And it's showing some questions that are in that default category. I might want another category. Click on exam 1, which has some questions in it. And a different set of questions have now popped up on the right side of the screen. These are questions that are in the question bank. None of these have been added to the quiz at this point. If you want to use a question that's already here, you simply click on the box, then scroll to the bottom with selected Add to Quiz. Click Add to Quiz. And that question has now popped into the quiz. It has one question in the quiz, right? Now, it also tells you the kind of question this is. This is a multiple choice question. We'll get to that in just a minute. You can edit the question. You'll see the pencil here. That's an editing icon. You can edit the question if you need to. Or if you want to see what the question looks like to a student, come over here and click Preview. And that is how the question would look to students, which is the following evidence that Dalton used, and the students then selects the answer. Notice there's only one question in the test right now. So the next button is here, and if I click next, it's not going to go anywhere. But let's go back to edit quiz, because we need to get more questions in there. Now, these are using questions that I already have in the question bank. But let's say I need to create a new question. Click create a new question. You have another screen. You have a number of different choices you have to make here. What type of question do you want this to be? Do you want it to be a multiple choice, true or false, short answer, a numerical, a calculated, essay, matching? There are a variety of options. And let's say you want to do a multiple choice. Click multiple choice, click next. And then you have the screen for this particular question. Notice the red asterisk. You have to give it a name for something. I've never figured out good ways of naming questions other than numbers, so I'll just call this question 2 for no particular reason. Then you put in the actual question text. Put in the actual question text. You can actually type it in. This is part of the tedious problem, Moodle. What is the largest planet in the solar system? Okay. The default mark is 1, meaning if they get it right, they get 1 point. You can change that if you want to give it multiple points. That depends on how you structure your quizzes. But you have to have something in that box. Notice it has a red asterisk. You might want to think about some general overall feedback that you want to give to students once they take the test. Another decision for this one multiple choice question, is there only going to be one answer, or are you going to have more than one possibility as a right answer? Choose whichever one you're going to use. I'm going to choose only one answer because there's only one largest planet in the solar system. Doesn't make sense to have more than one. Do I want it to shuffle the choices within the question? That is, two students won't necessarily have the A, B, C, D in the same order. I generally don't, so I will uncheck that. The default is yes. The default will come up. That is checked. Do you want to use ABC? You want to use capital ABC? You want to use 1, 2, 3? However you want your quiz to look when the students take it. It's going to use numerical numbers for the number of the questions, so I'd generally choose either ABC or capital ABC for the choices, just to distinguish that from the number of the question. Then you have to put in your choices. Are you going to use 4 choices? 3 choices, 5 choices, whatever your case may be, but you've got to enter a choice for each one. What is the largest planet in the solar system? Choice A is I'm going to put Mars. But Mars is not the correct answer, so the grade is none for that. If a student chooses that, do I want to give them some feedback on that wrong answer? If so, then I would add the feedback in this block here. Choice 2, let's put Jupiter. Jupiter is the correct answer, so I want to put 100% of the grade there. Again, do I want to give any feedback? Choice 3, let's put Saturn. It is not the correct answer, so I don't give it any grade. And choice 4, let's put Uranus. And Uranus is not the correct answer either. You have the option for choice 5 if you want to go to 5 choices for multiple choice. From testing and measurement theory, which is also one of the courses that I teach, there's not a lot of discriminatory difference in figuring out which students know the material and which students don't between 4 choices and 5 choices in multiple choice questions. The wrong answers are sometimes difficult to come up with, so why bother to try to come up with the 4th wrong answer is my way of thinking about that. You also can give even more. You can get up to 8 choices because you can click this and get 5 more blanks, 3 more blanks for correct choices. So you can get a total to 8 if you need them. Do you want to give any good feedback for any correct response, for a partially correct response, or for incorrect responses? Whether or not you want to give the feedback is up to you, but you have to put it into the system. Penalty for each incorrect try is 100% penalty if you're going to grade it as either right or wrong. But again, notice that that is a red asterisk, so you have to have something in that particular block. Do you want to give students a hint about if they're getting the wrong? I don't use those for multiple choice questions. I generally don't give students hints. You have 2 built in. If you need them, you can add another one. Okay. Then scroll to the bottom, save the changes. But you don't see that question here because that question has gone into the item bank. And it's always highlighted in pink. So find if you want that one in your quiz, and you come over here and find it, check the box, and add it to the quiz. And there's your second question in the quiz. What's the largest planet in the solar system? Now, that is where you are entering all of the text that you need for the questions. You do have the capability, if you have questions available in other formats, such as in a Word file, you can actually copy and paste into the questions in Moodle. Let's do another multiple choice, and I will demonstrate how to do one of those. I'll give this one the name 03 for some particular reason. And now I have a set of questions that's in a Word file. I have them parked on my desktop, so I just switch to the Word file. I want to copy that question, switch back to Moodle, and there's a quirk in Moodle. If you're used to using right clicks a lot for copy and paste, when you get back into Moodle, you're going to have to use the Control V or the Command V key to get it back into Moodle. Now, here's a little quirk because of the format of the test that I just copied from. I was using the bulleted listing on the previous test, so it actually picked up that command. I don't want that to look like that in Moodle, so I have to undo that. And that may be something that you need to do. If you've used those listing commands in a Word file, it will carry those. If you're copying and pasting, it will carry those into Moodle, and you have to undo those. Otherwise, it looks odd. Make the same decisions that you made earlier on the other multiple choice question. The default mark, one answer only. I don't want it to shuffle the choices. Then I have to go back to my Word file if I want to copy the choices. Back to Moodle. See, I inadvertently used the click, and I got the message that said it is not available in Mozilla and Firefox. So I have to remember to go back and use the Command or Control key. And again, undo the listing. That is not the right answer to the question. Francis Bacon is not the right answer to who first proposed the theory of continental drift. So he gets none for the grade. Back to the Word file. Let's highlight Alfred Wegener. Copy Wegener. Put it in. Wegener happens to be the right answer. So we'll give that one 100% for the grade. Isaac Newton. is my third choice. And choices 1, 3, and 4 have a grade of none because none of those are the right answers. I'm not going to add any more choices. The penalty for an incorrect try is 100%. And so finally, I save changes. We have created the question, but you will now notice again it's not yet in the quiz. So back to the question bank to pick up the question we just created. Click it. Scroll to the bottom, add to the quiz. And you'll notice there's a little lag in Moodle when this happens. It happens all the time. That lag is there. And you'll notice now the question is in the quiz. I've got 3 multiple choice questions in there right now. So just to get an idea of what it might look like now to students, let's go to preview. Let's see what these 3 questions would look like. And this would be how the quiz would appear to the students at this point. The questions and then the choices for multiple choice. And again, you have the next button down here if you have set it up by pages. But let's continue with editing the quiz because we want to take a look at some of the other question types.